Hello, and welcome to the A Ball and All a podcast. My name is Mpho Mutlwane. You can follow me on Twitter at Mpho Moreki. You can follow us on the Ball and All show on YouTube, where this video will be posted, as well as on Anchor, the podcast platform, but I'm also on iTunes as well, on Apple Podcasts as well, on the Ball and All podcast on Apple Podcasts, so you can go and check it out there. It's episode 5 of the season. Sorry, I didn't record last week. It was knee-deep in cricket, but we're back in again. This week, we're talking All-Stars. All-Stars in the East, All-Stars in the West. The NBA announced that they have agreed this week to have the All-Star game. 2 weeks ago, All-Star voting opened up. Well, last week, All-Star voting opened up. And this week, they said they will have an All-Star game in Atlanta. I think in this COVID world, a lot of the players are saying, like LeBron said this morning after beating the Nuggets, that he seemingly said it was like irresponsible. It's like slapping him in the face. That's what he said. And obviously Darren Fox said it wasn't the best decision ever from the NBA. They could have just announced the All-Stars and that would have been it, and guys would have gotten paid and their bonuses and everything else. But the game will happen. So far, Kevin Durant is leading LeBron by about 100,000 votes, 2.4 million. LeBron's about 2.3. And so it's shaping up. But I wanted to just discuss my All-Star teams. And from the East and the West, and what I would have selected. Obviously, the first five are selected by the fans, including myself. And so you vote every day, and you vote on NBA.com. Also, you can hashtag the player's name with NBA All-Star, and they will read the votes on Twitter as well. For the starters, and then the starters are selected by the fans. Then the coaches and the players vote for the reserves here, and so that's an interesting one. So I'm going to talk about the guys I think are lock-ins, guys I think should be there, and then also about guys who didn't make it in. So let's get going. Also, just a sub thing to note with the standings, the 76ers are still leading at the top. They are 2 games ahead of the Bucks and the Nets, which is something that is fascinating for Doc Rivers' team. I think he's done an incredible job with the 76ers. But the team that had the longest win streak this week were the Houston Rockets. They won 7 games in a row, only to lose, I think it was 2 days ago, 2 days ago against the Oklahoma City Thunder. But it seems like Victor Oladipo, Christian Wood, John Wall, DeMarcus Cousins are seemingly working it out with that Houston Rockets team there. But there'll be a lot of trades for that Houston Rockets team. But it's really nice for a new coach, Steven Silas, to get the team winning. They've shot up the defensive standings as well. I think they're number 2 now in the best defensive team defense. The Lakers came back from their 10-game road trip. They lost 3 games on that road trip that took them down the standings. But they are still looking very scary because it doesn't look like they've hit full gear. Anthony Davis needs to figure out a way to get himself going. And he's having a slow start to this. He's having a slow start to the season and not hitting his ink. But there are moments. So the thing is, if you watch a Lakers match, there's a quarter or a period in a quarter where the Lakers will go all in on defense and it's just lockdown. And they get turnovers. They get, like today against the Nuggets, they had a 24-point swing. They were 12 points down at the start of the 5-minute mark in the third quarter. They got to 7 minutes later, they were 12 points ahead of the Nuggets. That's the type of defense that the Lakers are doing. The Clippers are looking very good. Like last season, they looked very good. It's just a question of how they'll do in the playoffs. Paul George is having a great season. The problem with them, and I played the Brooklyn Nets earlier this week, and it was a 1-score game, the Nets winning. Kyrie was just incredible, electrifying, scored about 39 points in that game, and the rest of them were just pitching in. The problem with the Clippers is that without having a point guard, so whoever gets the rebound gets the ability to bounce the ball down to the half court, and then they don't have any half court, so everyone just sits in their spots. So if like Zubac will go down low, if it's not Zubac, it's Batum, he'll try to go inside, and everyone just hangs around the three-point shot, no movement, nothing, and that kind of needs to work out. I wrote an interesting article this week on Post-Up Zone, so please do check it out at postupzone.com. It's about the Mavericks, the Heat, and the Raptors, the three teams who were playoff teams last year who aren't in the playoff spots right now. They currently are low they currently are below 500, which means they've lost more games than they've won. The Mavericks are in 13th, the Heat are in 13th, and the Raptors are in 10th in the East. And so I wrote about how their chances are. So please do check that out at postupzone.com. Please do support us there as well. So let's get into the East All-Stars. The West All-Stars first. I think the West is slightly easier. The East is a little bit more complicated because there's so many people that can make it in the East. The guys are having career seasons in the East. So if you look at the West All-Stars, Steph Curry is at the top of the battle in the backcourt with Damian Lillard. I think they're the two guys who have really stepped up the season for their teams. They don't have great teams. I think Steph has elevated this team. He's done an incredible job. But like Portland, one of the worst defenses in the league, and it's really hurting them. And obviously the injury to CJ McCollum. Pick LeBron James, Paul George, Nikola Jokic. That I picked Paul George over Kawhi because I feel Paul George is having a much better season than Kawhi. Career numbers from a Paul George. He's averaging 24 points per game. He's also got 5.6 rebounds and 5.5 assists, 6.2 rebounds and 5.5 assists. So he's having a career year. You can put Kawhi Leonard in there. For me, it was whichever one of the Clippers, but the other two are set. Nikola Jokic, probably he was voted Western Conference Player of the Week last week. It was the first time that him and Joel Embiid's the Eastern Player of the Week. It's the first time that two centers from each conference were Players of the Week since I think Dwight Howard and Yao Ming, and when Dwight was in Orlando. So that was a lot while back. We've got that. You've also got for me the reserves. These guys are locks: Luka Doncic, Donovan Mitchell, Kawhi Leonard, Anthony Davis, Rudy Gobert. You'd add the Suns pair of Devin Booker and Chris Paul. I think a lot of the coaches will vote for them. But they're guys who are missing out, who I kind of felt probably would need to, Brandon Ingram could probably put in there. You could put Zion in there. I think Zion's averaging 20 points per game. He's averaging 23 points per game, seven rebounds, and 2.5 assists. So you could possibly consider him in there. The other guys that aren't in that are in the West, you could look at De'Aaron Fox, 22 points per game. Christian Wood is one who is playing really good football, really good basketball as a center for the Houston Rockets. He's taken leaps and bounds. Shai Gilgeous-Alexander could come into that 11 and 12 spot. Mostly these are the guys in the East. It's pretty much simple. It's pretty much a standard CJ McCollum as well. But because they're playing the game, CJ's injured, so he won't be able to play, but he might get a vote in. But for me, that 12th spot with Chris Paul, it could go to CJ. It could go to Brandon Ingram, Christian Wood, a little bit too early. Zion, if you want to consider Zion. I think the Pelicans guys, they haven't played great basketball. So quite frankly, there's nothing much. But I'm happy that I think Donovan Mitchell will get a shoe in, get a call up. Mike Conley's another one that you need to consider. The Jazz have just played some incredible basketball. They are the best three-point shooting team in the league. And Mike Conley's really helped this team step up from a backcourt perspective with Donovan Mitchell, really one of the strongest backcourts in the league. Obviously, and in the West, you've got that Devin Booker CP3 backcourt as well. So that's my Western All-Stars. In the East, it's a little bit tougher, but let's go through it. I think there'll be a lot of people who are angry in the East, and I'll tell you who those people are. But here's my All-Star selection in the East. Let's put it up again. You've got Jaylen Brown from the Celtics in that backcourt with James Harden. You've got KD, Giannis, and Joel Embiid. I think The Celtics fans would should come through for Jaylen Brown. He's such an incredible player. He's had this is his career season as well. He's grown in leaps and bounds, 26 points per game, 5.5 rebounds, 3.5 assists. He's really stepped it up as well. And so he deserves to be a starter this year. And then obviously the guys who are locks in the West, I think, Bradley Beal having another high scoring season, 34 points per game is Bradley Beal is averaging. He deserves to be in the game. He missed out last year on the All-Star, even though he was putting up such high numbers. Trae Young from the Hawks. Trae Young is always a high scoring guard, 26.5 points per game, 26.6 points per game, and 9 assists. He comes into that reserves. I think the coaches will vote for him. Jason Tatum. Domantas Sabonis is one of the two best centers in the East. Chris Middleton from the Bucks. I think Chris Middleton's having a better year. I think Giannis is having, you would say Giannis is having somewhat of a down year, but Chris Middleton is there and thereabouts for his team at 20.7 points per game, with 6.3 rebounds and 5.9 assists. Chris Middleton, by the virtue of him being on the Bucks, I think it would be. And there are a lot of guys who might question that, but I'd say you put him in. Kyrie Irving. Here's the question for these next two. There's a lot of other guys who can come in from the perspective of 11 and 12. Kyrie Irving is averaging 28 points per game. Right now, he is on fire, one of the best guards in the East. He hasn't played a lot of games. Obviously, he's missed a lot of games. Some guys have played 22. He's played 15. Has he done enough to be an all-star? In my books, it's a yes. You'd have to put all three. And there's another question as to possibly even having him instead of Jaylen Brown at the top. So you'd have a Kyrie, James Harden backcourt in that East All-Stars. But it's very competitive in the East, but Kyrie will be in there. And then the other one I've picked is Julius Randle. He's having a career year. For that last spot, it was between, and I'll give you the names. It was Julius Randle. It was Zach LaVine. It was Nikola Vucevic, Colin Sexton, and Andre Drummond of the Cleveland Cavaliers, and also Fred VanVleet and Kyle Lowry as well for that last spot. I went with Julius Randle largely because of the fact that Julius Randle is averaging triple-double numbers. Let me give you Julius Randle's numbers. Oh, yes, and Bam Adebayo as well. He could also come into the reckoning there. But I picked Julius Randle because I think for this Knicks team, the improvement that this Knicks team has made, he is playing at an all-star level, 22.6 points per game, 10.9 rebounds, and six assists, which is pretty much incredible. Nikola Vucevic, 22.5 points, 11.2 rebounds per game, and 3.5. So he will feel, if he doesn't make it, he'll feel like he's been left out. Malcolm Brogdon also, 22 points per game for the Pacers. If you go down this list, it's just incredible. The guys Tobias Harris and Ben Simmons from Philadelphia will also be questioning. Bam Adebayo as that center. I chose Sabonis over Bam Adebayo for 20 points per game, but Bam could also make it into that list. Let me just put it up again. Could make it into that list. For instance, like I said, Chris Middleton might be questioned as to whether he's an all-star or not. But by the virtue that Miami's not playing well, it's been a real struggle for Miami. I wrote it in the article, so if you want to know what I feel about Miami, go into the article. They've got the pieces. They've got the veteran knowledge. It's just not coming together for Miami. And also the Toronto guys, Siakam, Lowry and VanVleet. It's a little bit too late. You can see that they're now finally getting that identity. They're starting to win a few games, but I think it's a little bit too late. But those are my East. Let me show you my West All-Stars. We'll check it when the results come out. And then also the East All-Stars here for you to see. Let me know what you think about these All-Stars, who you think I've missed out. I know there are a lot of Zach LaVine fans on and they want him in. He's having a year, and he's a really great third piece for a team that's looking to chase a championship. But I just picked Julius Randle. I really, maybe it's a Lakers bias. You can call me out on that. But I really do think at the Knicks, he's done an incredible job. But either way, the East has so many guys. Gordon Hayward's also one of the guys who might miss out on this, and he'll feel hard done by. So, yeah, so I think that's where I'm going to leave it now. Enjoy this weekend of NBA basketball. There's a Super Bowl going, so I don't think there'll be a lot of people watching NBA basketball. Please do enjoy it. Like, it's some really great basketball being played in the NBA. It's really high quality. The Pelicans go to the Pacers tonight. The Raptors play the Nets on ESPN tomorrow morning. Some really great games. Boston Celtics play the Clippers on a Saturday night as well. Sunday morning. Tonight, actually, tomorrow morning, Saturday morning for us, is a Friday night, so do check that out. The Knicks play the Philadelphia 76ers on Saturday night, Sunday morning for the South Africans. Some really great game. Golden State play Dallas. That's going to be a thriller minute, another in the series between Golden State and the Dallas Mavericks. They're playing a baseball-style series, and Kelly Oubre scored 40 points. He just went and scored 40 points on Dallas. It's just unbelievable. Well, look, it's not unbelievable. You knew that Kelly Oubre had it in him, and he just chose this game to come through. And the Golden State Warriors will be hoping that it continues. The Charlotte Hornets are playing some incredible basketball. LaMelo Ball is just looking just incredible. There's an interesting stat. I think that the Charlotte Hornets are 6-2, 6 wins and 2 losses in games where LaMelo Ball has contributed to 25 or more statistical points. So if he scored 16 points and 9 rebounds, that's 25. They win 6 out of the games, and 2. And he's rebounding, he's assisting, and also he's scoring points. So it's some really great watches to hang your head over. Houston's not a bad watch anymore, which is something incredible as well to see. But really do enjoy your week in basketball, and we'll chat next week. And also look out for my articles next week. I'm thinking I might do something on the Utah Jazz. But you still let me know if you'd like me to cover anything else and give me your thoughts on the show. Thank you very much, and enjoy the week. Le sale, kakakiso.